So this is equal to c squared plus minus integral from minus infinity to plus infinity. And here, when h is applied on psi n, I know that it is equal to n plus half h bar omega. From this equation, that when h applies on psi, it gives e psi, and this e is here n plus half h bar omega. So I have written this plus minus half and psi n. So this will be inside a curly bracket here, and we will have a complete bracket and conjugate, and then psi n dx, and this thing is equal to c square plus minus. Now h omega, h bar omega here and here, it is cancelled, and we are left only with numbers. So this is n plus half plus minus half, and integral from minus infinity to plus infinity, and psi n conjugate psi n dx. Now I know from here that psi n conjugate psi n is psi n mod square, and it is equal to 1. So this one goes to 1, and we are left with c square plus minus n plus half plus minus half, and this thing is equal to 1. So this implies that c, if I move the c square another side, means this on other side, and I take square root on both sides, then I will see that c plus minus is equal to 1 over n plus half plus minus half square root. So this implies that c plus is equal, if I consider plus only, then half plus half is 1. So I'm having c plus equals n plus 1 square root, while c minus, these two will cancel, and I will have only 1 over n c minus. So I have derived the two constants, which were c plus and c minus. So from here I can write that psi n plus 1. So this implies that psi n plus minus 1 is equal to c plus minus and a plus minus psi n. So this implies that psi n plus 1 is equal to c plus, which is 1 over n plus 1 square root a plus psi n, while psi n minus 1 is equal to 1 over n a plus psi n. So from here I can further write that this implies that psi n means when a plus operates on psi n, then this one is minus. So when a plus operates on psi n, it gives n plus 1 square root psi n plus 1. And when a minus psi n is equal to n square root psi n minus 1. So from here, I can write that psi n plus 1 is equal to 1 over n plus 1 a plus psi n. Now for n equals 0, psi n means this psi n 0, so it will become psi 1 is equal 1 over 1, 0 plus 1, 1, a plus psi naught. Similarly, for n equals 1, psi 2 will be equal to 1 over, and this is square root as well. So 1 plus 1 is 2 square root, and psi a plus psi 1. Now this thing 1 over 2 square root and a plus, and for psi 1 I can write a plus psi 0. So this is equal, psi 2 is equal to 1 over 2 a plus 2 and psi 0. Similarly, for n equals 2, we have psi 3 is equal 1 over 2 plus 1, so 3 square root a plus psi 2. And this is equal to 1 over 3 square root a plus psi 2 is equal to this. So 1 over 2 and a plus 2 and psi naught. So psi 3 is equal to 1 over 3 dot 2 and a plus 3 psi naught. Similarly, for n equals 3, this will become psi 4, and this is equal to 1 over 4 and a plus psi 3. Now for psi 3 I can write this value. So this will be equal to 1 over 3 2 and a plus, so 1 a plus is here and another a plus 3 psi naught comes in here. And 1 over 4 from here. So here I will have 1 over 4 square root. So this implies that psi 4 is equal to 4, 3, 2. And a plus 4 psi naught. So by proceeding this, we come to know that psi n will be equal, this is actually 4 factorial, this is 3 factorial, this is 2 factorial, and here is 1 factorial. So we can write that psi n is equal to 1 over n factorial square root a plus to the power n and psi naught. So this is our generalized form of the normalization constant. So our normalization constant come is 1 over n factorial square root. Just like an infinite square, well, we can now prove that the wave function or the states of harmonic oscillator are orthonormal as well. So the orthonormality of the states of harmonic oscillator is, we derived that psi n is equal to 1 over n factorial a plus to the power n psi naught. We can take any other state, like psi n is any state, psi 1, psi 2, psi 3, so on. Another state is psi m, and this will be then equal to m factorial a plus to the power m and psi naught. Now n and m are numbers. For example, our numbers are starting from 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, and they go to, let's say, infinity. Now in between these numbers, any number is n and any other number is m, and we assume here that m is greater than n. So means n is in any lower number while m is any higher number. So now I will have to see the normalization, the orthonormality condition. Let me write this condition. This is from minus infinity to plus infinity, psi m conjugate psi n dx is equal to delta mn, where this is equal to 1 f m is equal to n, and this is equal to 0 f m is not equal to n. So this is a Kronecker delta. We know the property of this, and we know one thing, that psi n and psi m are normalized. That is, that from minus infinity to plus infinity, psi m mod square dx is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, psi n mod square dx, and both are equal to 1, which means they are normalized. So let me now check the orthonormality condition. This implies that from minus infinity to plus infinity, psi m conjugate and psi n dx is equal to, put the values of psi m and psi n, so we will have m factorial 1 over n factorial, and then integration from minus infinity to plus infinity, and a to the power m, because m is earlier, psi naught and the conjugate of it, and a to the power n, and these will be plus as well, and psi n, psi naught, and dx. So this thing is equal to, is, we remember that when I want this one to move here, then a plus will change into a minus, and n, so this is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, a minus to the power n, and a plus to the power m, and psi naught conjugate, and psi naught and dx. So we have done till this, and now I will apply some conditions on this one. I know one thing, that when a plus operates on psi n, then it is some constant of normalization. So approximately this is psi n plus 1, and when a minus operates on psi n, then it is psi n minus 1. Now if I write this one, that a plus to the power n, this is any number, and it operates on psi naught, for example, on psi naught, then it will increase this one, and how many times? N times. So it will become psi n. And if a minus operates on m, then it will, a minus operates on to the power m on psi naught, then it will lower it, then it will lower it to psi n minus m. So we will have to see this thing. Okay, a minus when operate on psi naught, then it will give us zero, because a minus to the power 1 when operates on this one, it will give zero. Now any other higher power operating on psi naught will also give zero. So this gives us the idea that is only a minus operate on psi naught, psi naught being the ground state. This one is raising it and this one is lowering it. So now if a minus to the power m operates on psi n, now if psi n is any state, so it will approximately lower this one to any other state, such that it will be psi n minus m. Now what will happen if n is lower and m is greater? If m is greater than n,